Now we will learn about column vector. Column vector is written in this shape, in the shape of a column. This can be written as 1i plus 2j. That means it will move 1 unit along x-axis and 2 unit along y-axis. This I is the unit vector along x-axis and this j is the unit vector along y-axis. What does unit vector I or j represents? If this is x-axis and this is y-axis, then 1 unit along x-axis, this is unit vector I. 1 unit along y-axis, this is unit vector j. If I ask for 3i, 3i will be this vector, 1, 2, 3 unit. If I say 2j, 2j will be this vector, 1 unit, 2 unit. This is the case of unit vector. Now, what about vector A? Vector A is 1, 2. That means vector A is such a vector, it will move 1 unit along x-axis and 2 unit along y-axis. So, in column vector, this is delta x change in x-axis, this is delta y change in y-axis. If I want to represent A, for example, I start A from here, 1i, that means it will move 1 unit along x-axis and 2j, it will move 2 unit along y-axis. That means this is our A vector. We can start from any point. We could have start from here, 1 unit to x-axis, 2 unit to y-axis. We could have been drawn A like that. Now the vector B. Vector B is minus 5, 2. Here delta x equal to minus 5, delta y equals to 2. That means it will move 5 unit left side. If this is a negative value, it will move in minus x axis. That means in this way. So minus 5. Let's start it from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And delta y is 2. That means 2 units upward. 1, 2. Therefore, our B vector will be this, and it can be also written as minus 5i plus 2j, where I and j are unit vector along x-axis and y-axis. Now the vector C is 3 minus 1. That means it can be written as 3i minus 1j. That means from the initial point, it will move 3 units along x-axis. That means positive x-axis, right side. 1, 2, 3. And it will move 1 unit along negative y-axis. Negative y-axis means downside. So this vector is C vector. Now let's see another vector. D minus 2 minus 3. That means here delta x is minus 2, it will move 2 units left. Delta y equal to minus 3, it will move 3 unit downward. Negative x means left, positive x means right, negative y means down, positive y means up. How can we draw a D? Let's assume this is the beginning point. We can assume any point as the beginning point. It will move 2 unit left, minus 2. And for this minus 3 or for minus 3j, it will move 3 units down, 1, 2, 3. Therefore, this is our vector D. While writing any vector, the thing we should keep in mind that to write a vector, we must use the vector sign. Vector sign can be written as this or this or this or this. We can draw an arrow above or below the symbol, or we can simply put a bar sign above or below the symbol.
So from this video, I'm pretty sure that you have learned about the concept of column vector. I'm repeating again. For any column vector E, delta X, delta Y, the value above defines how much right or how much left we proceed. And the value delta Y defines how much above or how much down we will move. Delta X positive, we will move right. Delta X negative, we will move left. Delta Y positive, we will move up. Delta Y negative, we will move down. And the process of drawing a vector from its column vector, I have shown you in this graph.